दिस वीडियो सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द इंडक्शन मोटर विच इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इंजीनियरिंग एंड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एज वेल एज ऑटोमोबाइल ब्रांचेस. द मेन कंटेंट ऑफ दिस वीडियो आर इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द इंडक्शन मोटर, नेसेसिटी ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मोटर, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द इंडक्शन मोटर. लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस फर्स्ट अबाउट द इंडक्शन मोटर. इंडक्शन मोटर इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर आर द मोस्ट कॉमन एंड फ्रीक्वेंटली एनकाउंटेड मशीन इन द इंडस्ट्रीज. If you look at the design of the induction motor, it's look very simple, rugged. Also, the price of the induction motor is very low and easy to maintain it. That means maintenance is also a little bit less. Also, the induction motor run essentially as a constant speed from no load to full load. That is the one very important topic. Its speed is depends on the frequency of the power source and no easy to have a variable speed control. That is the main aspect about the induction motor. Why induction motor? The reason is only that it's robust, no brushes, no contacts on a rotor shaft. That is the main advantage. Also, the high power or weight ratio compared to the DC motor. That is the one advantage of a AC motor with respect to DC motor. Cost is also very less. Power consumption is also less. Manufacturing process is also a little bit very easy. Almost maintenance free, we can say that. Except for bearing and other mechanical parts. Because in the bearing and some another mechanical part, it requires a little bit more maintenance. Look at the various types of the induction motor. AC motor is divided into two segments, AC as well as DC motor. Another part of AC motor and DC motor, it is written in this slide for your knowledge and information. Let me introduce first the principle of this motor, or we can say principle of the operation. A rotating magnetic field denoted by RMF is set up in the stator when a three-phase supply is given. That means when three-phase supply is given to that motor, stator can start the work and as a result it rotating the magnetic field. The stationary rotor cut the revolving field and due to electromagnetic induction and EMF is induced in the rotor conductor. This point is related with the principle of the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic inductions. As you all know that in case of the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic inductions, change in the magnetic flux will induce the electromotive force, that is the EMF. As the rotor conductor is short circuited, current flows through them and it becomes a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field start the rotating. Look at the image of the cut section of the induction motor. The various part of the induction motors are frame, starter winding, rotor winding, cooling fan, and last it is the bearings. These are the main part of the induction motor, and this is nothing but it's a cut view section of the three phase induction motor. What are the applications of the induction motor? General purpose with a normal torque and a normal starting current. This point can be applied to the fans, blowers, centrifugal pumps, line shafting, etc. Also, the one more advantage of this motor is that high torque, low starting current. For that, it is widely used in conveyors, compressors, crushers, agitators, reciprocating pumps, etc. Also, torque is very high, medium and high slip. So the applications of this field is used for the high inertia loads, punch pressers, die engineering, etc.